that we're going to work. Amen.
Amen.
So that for those of you who were not here yesterday, you can sit down for a moment. Amen.
Amen.
For those of you who were not here yesterday, it's not going to be church as usual. Amen?
Amen.
It's not going to be a traditional kind of church.
Yes.
Are you guys with me?
Yes.
Because today we really want to deal with some foundational things. And we really want to pray. Amen?
Yes.
So in order to pray, you know, my challenge with church is there is always so much to do, but very little time. We can go to parties and stay long, but in the house of God, we are always looking at the time.
Sorry, our children, if you can go to your service, please. Sorry.
Children's service. Let my grandbaby also go.
Children, I don't know your teachers if they are.
Oh, the blood of Jesus. And God was moving so powerfully.
Yeah.
How many of you were here yesterday?
Yeah.
It was a glorious time in the presence of the Lord.
Yeah.
And when I went home, I had to think about what happened yesterday. Jesus himself was here.
Amen.
Do you know how I know? Because whenever God comes, he speaks.
Yes.
I'm not talking about the word I preach or what we were sharing. I'm talking about revelation. Jesus came and he spoke. The theme is, I am pregnant and ready to give birth. And I believe so many of the people of God are pregnant.
Yes.
But they are somehow not giving birth. So many of you are going through changes. And God is so faithful. You know, whenever God calls you to a meeting like that, it means you've been selected by God.
Amen.
Somebody say, I've been selected by God.
Amen.
It means you've been chosen by God to be favored.
Yes.
God does not just call people because he wants people to come. When God wants to change your life,
amen,
he gives you an invitation.
Amen.
And I'm so glad many of you came yesterday. Because I believe there is a turnaround about to happen in your life.
Amen.
And I'm happy you came today.
Yes.
Because there is a turnaround about to happen in your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What did God speak yesterday? You have to remember the Bible says, God does not put new wine in old wine skin. How many of you believe that?
Amen.
So why God wants to fill us in? Why God wants to give you a vision? Why God wants to give you a purpose? God needs to clean us up first.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I told you yesterday, when you are too full, God cannot use you.
Amen.
God cannot pour himself into you.
Yes.
When you are too full.
Yes.
So what God wants to do is empty us first.
Yes.
Because God is tired of church.
Yes.
God is tired of us playing.
Yes.
And acting as if we really need God.
Yes.
Churches, and sadly enough, I always see the same people at the altar. The same sister will jump, and fall out. At the conference, I mean, the same person.
Mm-hmm.
So, what happened the first time when you fell out? What happened the second time when you were at the altar? What happened the third time? Something is wrong.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Some of you ought to be preaching by now. Some of you ought to be discipling people by now.
Yes.
But you are still babies.
Babies.
We need to be praying for you.
Yes.
Begging you to come to church. Let every service for the first one to come here. You know, you need to stop the game.
Amen. 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 Amen.
We need to stop the drama. There is too much acting in the house of God.
Yes.
Some of you women just want to be touched by men.
Yes.
So you come to the It's not about God. It's about your lustful spirit. Am I talking to somebody else?
Amen. Amen.
You just want to be seen. You want attention. But there's something change going on in your spirit. These are altars you didn't even 10 years ago. The altar is still there.
Just
here.
Yes.
I saw some of you as he bowed. build an altar for God like Elijah did. You need to call on fire to consume the gods and idols upon your altar. You are coming to church with the Bible. At home, some of you still have objects from Africa. Scriptures, pray.
Embraces light. Darkness repels light.
if you have nothing to hide, you will run away from God. That's what Adam did. When Adam knew he was in sin, he went down to feelings and he hid himself from the presence of God. But God does not want you to hide anymore. God doesn't want you to hide anymore. Don't do those secret things that God already knows about them. God already knows about them. But what God is saying, give it to me. God said, give it to me. God himself went to get Adam. It wasn't Adam who went to God. Just like today, God is coming to you. He is coming to your heart. And God really wants to destroy the works of darkness in your life. Let's open our Bible because we need to pray so. I just want to declare some scriptures. I'm really going to pray. You must prepare your heart for God. The harvest is here. Partaker of the harvest. Amen. Open your Bible to 1 John 3 and 8. Is God talking to somebody today?
Amen. Hallelujah.
God so loves you. He doesn't want you to miss it. He doesn't want you to miss heaven with him. But God is not already committed to take you to heaven. He wants to give you heaven on earth.
Amen.
That's why Jesus came. To give you life. And life more abundantly.
Amen.
Some of you think you are living, but you're dead. Because Christ wants to give you life for real. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
He wants to give you life. Why do I say it's that you are dead? Because from the dead you were born to now. Right where you are, behind, God can reach you. But when people keep sinning, it shows that they belong to the devil, who has been sinning since the beginning. But the Son of God came to destroy the works of the devil. Do you hear that? It doesn't matter the bondage in your life, the strongholds, the altars. The Son of God came to destroy the work of the devil. So we want God to destroy the works of the devil in your life. How many of you have said, God, whatever it is in my life today, destroy it? If that's your way to stand to your feet, right where you are, you want Jesus alone today. They're not going to be screaming and shouting. If you say, God, I am here today, destroy the